This 86 GMC half-ton truck. The only true way to do one of these vehicles right is to take this latch assembly out. And when I take this apart, you're gonna see all this mechanism's gonna, the gaskets are bad. I'm gonna repair those and fix it for them. What I'm gonna do, I've never got this thing started, is a roll pin here that you drive out. That's why I rolled that up. But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna turn this back. I'm gonna show you an easy way to break the glass, but the only way to get it out is with a roll pin driver. And I've lost my hammer, so this right here is redneck hammer time. Show them down there on the, there's a hole up here on this side, but it always drives out through the bottom. When you get this thing started and drive the roll pin out, and once you get started coming out, take these pliers. I like using a pair of diagonals or side cutters. Now when this comes out, be careful because it's spring loaded. There's a spring right here. You lay it down like this right here. You keep all this shit together. For folks that can't remember shit, keep it together so you just put it right back. Now over here, if you look at this, there's a spring steel washer here that keeps tension against that. Now, this is what always falls apart. This is what centers it. Come up here on top and show them now. See all this crusty shit right here? It's fixing to fall off. That's your seal that's broken. We're gonna put this over here. Now we're gonna take a torch bit. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna close this glass. Put it, there's a, come right here and show them, stick it in this hole right here. There's a torch bit up in there. So we're gonna take this, we'll slide it in real easy. Only the end of it in there now. We're gonna break it loose. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. When we take it apart, some of those things you have to hold on to all these pieces. And here's the other thing. As I lay this out, I'm gonna push it out. You're gonna see, make note of how it goes in there. The point goes to the top. That way you don't lose nothing or mess nothing up, because it is a specific way it goes and the point does go to the top. Inside seal out, it's broken all the pieces. I'll create him another one, put it back on there. And this one is more of a rubber and it goes in the hole and centers it up. It has a lip on this gasket, which centers it up in the hole. Anyway, this gives us ample room to cut, do the vent glass and all that, and we can get all this off. Next step we do is all this rubber in this groove, I turn my knife, I got a 30 degree blade, I'll turn it back at an angle, and I go in there and I trim all this out from in this edge, so I can do a gapless install. It allows me to install the film down below the surface on this. You trim it like that, then you're good to go. All that good stuff. I'll do that. What's old guy's name does all the painting the trees and shit? Bob somebody. I stole his brush. That's why you don't see him no more. He retired.
Foose or Goss or Boss or...
Yeah, him. White man with the afro. I figured out the reason he painted trees all the time because he dreamed about being high, but his job wouldn't let him. Anyway, that's that. All right, here's what we're gonna do. You see this little notch? This is very important when you're hand cutting these things. This lets it slip in here over this hinge. If you don't, you'll end up with it crinkled up right there. It'll look like ball sack. All right, now. Minimum water, just put it up over there and make this thing stick. And you want to tack it down really well. And what I'm going to do, down here where this film goes into the groove up here, I'm going to take this squeegee that I got tacked down really good. I'm going to crease this thing purposely. And down here in this curve, this is where a lot of people has trouble. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take my knife blade, I'm gonna cut a relief in it, like that. That way it lays down. Now a lot of folks will dull their blade and cause themselves grief by trying to dig this thing up in here like this to make it work. So I'm gonna show you the correct way to do it with your knife. And I may not video it because I might start cussing, but you want to take it and put it straight down. I'm going to take this this marker. And I'm gonna run it right down through here and create a pattern, because I'm gonna use this liner to send to Film and Vinyl Designs, because their pattern sucks. So let's get that, and we're gonna ease it down through here like this. Even though I'm gonna cut that. I thought I'd explain to you why I was marking it with that marker. And when I take it off, I'll know what we got. Now, so this right here don't give me grief up here. I'm gonna cut this a little bigger.
Hey, Ron, you want me to get this to where you can roll this one down? It'd be
nice if you could, so when I install it, worked a little better.
Yeah.
But I'm just going up through here and cutting this little piece of film out so I'll have room. And if you ever want to tag, don't pull in, you'll rip your film. Hold your finger tight and snatch it out like this. It'll leave a little dog ear on it. I'm gonna start right here and push this in. So what I'm gonna do, instead of trying to get up in here and cut an angle and mess up my blade or my edge, I'm gonna put this thing straight on it and cut straight into the glass. Let me move my hand. So we got a Richard Insider here holding the camera. Come over on the other side of my fat head and go straight on the knife right there so they can see. You show my bald spot on back of my head? Hold that thing up for you, goofy bastard. Now, in order to make this thing fit, you got to keep it straight on the thing to make a nice pattern. All right. Now, I'm going to take this. Get me a little room right here. And the reason I'm not finishing out on the top is because the top has a hunk out of the metal up here on the inside. It's a, I guess that's a factory option. Hell, I don't know. Yeah. But we got a perfect edge that will fit right up in there where we want to go. Now we're going to do the same thing over here in this edge. I don't try to cut and run all the way through the whole curve, because you'll end up causing yourself grief. So we're gonna hold this thing, we're gonna keep the knife straight on the glass. This way, we got a pattern that fits and don't give you fits. We're gonna walk it up just like that. Move down a little closer and hit it. Over here. Get that ready. I'm gonna bring it down through here. These old trucks here, they are tedious work. That's why we get $1,000 to tint one. Alrighty. Come right back up here on this edge. Get on the other side of me over. Y'all hear that music in the background? Dum, dum, dum. So Johnny Cash, ain't it? Now, we're gonna open this biatch, just like that. Run it up, run it down. Somebody says, I can do that faster. Sure you can, but when I get through, you show a close-up, don't get 3 foot away, and I'll show you mine. Anyway, that's how we do it. We got the pattern.
Well, guys, we've got the 86 GMC finished. 20% carbon FX all the way around.
This is the vent glass that we had taken apart to show you how we took it apart. I'll get over on the other side so you can see it. All the way down. This is how you do it correctly. And I'm showing you this thing these parts were broken. We fix it with O-rings to repair the rubber seals. No gaps. I'm gonna close this and I'll latch it. You can hear how tight it latches. You clicked right then, it pulled it up. No gaps. No trash. We need to clean the windows. We take pride in everything we do. For 35 years, we've done it this way. These trucks were new when I first started tinning. And we still do it the same as we did then. Hand cut, no gaps on the windows. We pull the latches. You don't catch us shortcutting anything. We're showing this to, this is gonna be a public video, and someone calls about a tent job, you know, and I know a lot of folks are price shopping, and that's wonderful. But here's the thing. Price without service is no bargain at all. I had one customer ask me, you know, if you're using a film that's got the same warranty, same color, same shade as the other guy, why would we want to choose you? Well, and I don't care how good the price is. If you don't get this kind of service and get this kind of attention to detail, then, you know, it's, you're not getting the value that you deserve. Anyway. Rodney McClure, Ace Window Tinting, 35 years in the business. Bremen, Georgia, 770-301-2693. Thank you guys, we appreciate your business. Have a great day.